Yo guys, here's a really quick and easy way to do a complete sky replacement using Photoshop. And the process itself is fairly simple. There's actually multiple ways of doing this, but I'm gonna show you the easiest ones and let's get right into them. Now in this picture, I have a really vibrant, really colorful sky already. So that makes my job a lot easier because since the sky is blue, it really stands out from all the other colors in the image. So I can easily track the colors and I can easily replace them with anything I like. So that's really important when getting started. You want to pick an image where the sky is visible. It needs to be a different color or at least be easily traceable. So for this example, the very easy thing I could just do is go into the quick selection right over here. And from here, I can select the quick selection tool. Make sure it's in plus. And just like that, I can make my selection of the sky just like that. Now another way of doing this would be going back into the quick selection tool and using this magic tool. Now I'm gonna press Command and D to deselect everything and let's try out the magic tool. So before messing with anything, on the top you can play around with the tolerance to make sure you select the right amount of the color. So as you can see, it already selected pretty much half of the sky already. And now what I can do is hold Shift to select additional colors within the same selection. And that pretty much just gave me a good outline of my sky. Now let's try the same thing with really low tolerance and let's see what that does. So Command D to deselect everything. And now I'm gonna have my tolerance to, let's say, about 7. And now as you guys could see, the tolerance is really low, so it only selected really close colors to the color I was picking. So I'm gonna press Shift again and let's select a color from right over here. Let's do another one from here. Another one from here, another one from here. So you can see the tolerance makes a big difference. So if I just increase the tolerance a little bit and then select the colors, it selects a whole wider range of those colors and the similar colors around it. So there we go, we almost have the entire sky selected. And these are some really easy ways to make the selection and replace the color. Now I'm gonna show you one more tool you could use, which actually does a really good job. And it actually works a lot better if you want to do some fine adjustments, like let's say if you have trees over here or something like that, which I luckily don't have, but if you have something like that, that tool would really help you and do the processing work of tracing and selecting the sky and removing things that don't need to be there. So deselect everything and let's go on the top menu, select, and from here select and mask. Now from here you can play around with the opacity. I have this on view so I can see whatever is in red is what's gonna stay, and I can bring down the opacity or bring it up just like this. So in this case I'm gonna go into the quick selection tool, and you guys can see it is doing a pretty good job of tracing out the sky and I'm pretty much done. Now let's say if I had some trees over here or something and I want to be a little more precise and remove the sky but keep the trees, I could use the fine edge brush tool and that would really help me fine out my selection. And I'm just gonna do that a little bit on the mountains here just to give you guys an idea. And from here we could also play with the edge detection a little bit, smoothness, feather, contrast, and you could pretty much find what works better for you. So I'm gonna make some quick fine adjustments, and once you're happy with the selection you can press OK from right here. And we have our selection selected. And now once we have a proper selection, no matter how you got it, we're gonna go down right over here and create a mask. Now I'm gonna press Option and press the mask button. And you guys could see it created a mask and blacked out everything that was in the selection. So this is what it would be like if I didn't press Option. So when we press Option, we tell it to do pretty much the reverse of that. So here we go, we have our sky completely removed and now we're able to replace it with whatever we like. So now I'm gonna bring in my sky from right here. Let me go with something like this. And I'm just gonna bring this layer down. And move it around to where I think it fits the best. So I think that looks pretty good. Let's try another selection of sky and let's see how that looks. So as you guys could see, once you have your mask in place, it's actually pretty easy to replace the sky with whatever you like. You could even go into the adjustments and tweak the colors and the contrast and everything to make the colors match and make the picture look as perfect as you want. And yeah guys, that will be it for today. If you like this video, let me know in a comment down below and subscribe for more videos just like this. And as always, thanks for watching.